Good morning. I would like to welcome you all to SEAMEO-Partners Lecture Series on Innovative Teaching Solution. Our webinar today is the second session in this series. We are currently offering three sessions under the theme of agility in cross-sector trend. In this lecture series, SEAMEO has invited our educational partners who are governmental agencies, developmental agency, and private enterprise from all around the world to come to share the advanced knowledge and expertise and up-to-date solutions that can contribute to teacher capacity development, improvement of teaching methods, student knowledge, and future skill development. We believe that this lecture series will also help in broadening your viewpoint in the technology used for education and also provide opportunities for all of us to explore new technologies and innovative teaching solutions. We would like to express our appreciation to 18 partners who will share the expertise and initiative to address learning loss and education disruptions during the pandemic. Since the pandemic is still with us and the remote learning is still needed, we hope that this session will be beneficial to all of us to keep learning continue. Before we get to today's lecture series, I would like to show you a video clip from SEAMEO Youth Action on COVID-19, which we ask students to submit their video clips to us, showing their life during the pandemic, either in singing, dancing, vlog, or storytelling. This video clips, we are going to show you it a great example of an innovative solution for teaching online. It's from a 19 years old student from Cebu, Philippines. She used a variety of simple techniques to make her storytelling appealing and keep her audience attention to her stories. She won the first prize on storytelling in SEAMEO initiative with this video clip. So let's watch an award-winning storytelling clip from Chloe Nicole Bora together before we proceed with our lecture series today. Thank you and enjoy today's sessions.
Sources. Sharing is caring, but not if it's fake news. Or COVID-19. Other than the threat of the virus, the pandemic has taken a huge toll on our mental health. During this time, it's completely normal to feel anxious, stressed, or scared. That is why it's also more important to take care of ourselves and our mental health. For me, personally, I kept myself busy. I went back to doing my hobbies that I never had time for before the pandemic, and also pick up new ones. I also made sure to check up on the people I love. After all, social distancing only applies to the physical aspect. Still have the internet.
Stop!
Oh, yeah.
Stop!
Yeah. So, life goes on, even our education. Yes, really. We even had a virtual moving up ceremony for junior high.
Thank you very much, Dr. Kritsachai, for that welcome message and the opening video clip. So we'd like to thank all our participants and greet them. Good morning, Piapa. Would you like to greet all our viewers online now? I think we have 966 joining us.
That's quite many participants for this morning. Good morning, everyone, and nice to see you again. My name is Piapa from SEAMEO Secretariat and Rafi.
Yeah, I'm Rafi. So we'll be handling the session for this day. This is our second lecture series. So before we start, I know that you're wondering, last week we asked for your photos that you shared with us and also the poll, but we have prepared this video presentation for our participants who submitted their videos using the hashtag SEAMEO-Partners. So friends, let us learn from this and enjoy the video clip that we have prepared specially for you. Okay, so we'd like to thank everyone who submitted their photos with us. Please continue to submit them and use the hashtag SEAMEO-Partners, or you may email them at webinar@seameo.org, and we hope to receive their submissions by tomorrow.
Yes, that's right. And then you can, you know, selfie yourself by using your mobile phone mm-hmm. with the computer screen that you are, you know, watching us from the YouTube live, so that, and submit the photo in your Facebook, and don't forget to hashtag SEAMEO-Partners.
Yes, and we have also seen so many innovative ways that our participants, educators, are accessing this and learning from this lecture series. We also have the poll link there. So just like last week, now we'd like to ask you, what do you like most about this lecture series? I believe my colleagues from the secretariat have pinned the link. Please participate by clicking on that link. So before we start with our lecture series, Piapa, would you like to give an overview of this second lecture series?
Thank you, Rafi. For today's session on innovative teaching solutions, we will feature four chapters, which are keynote speaker, digital transformation, innovative teaching solutions, and innovation for TVET. And today we have about seven presentations from six countries, such as like United Kingdom, Hong Kong, China, Singapore, Indonesia, and Thailand. Maybe we can start with the keynote speaker, Rafi.
So for the keynote presentation, we have with us Mr. Jonathan Ledger, TVET specialist from Department for International Trade, United Kingdom. And he will be talking about thinking bright, reaching farther. So friends, let us enjoy this lecture, and please prepare your handphones so that you can capture the essential and important points that our speaker will be sharing now. Thank you and enjoy this lecture.
Hi, my name is Jonathan Ledger and I'm the Global TVET Specialist at the Department for International Trade, London, UK, and I'm going to talk to you about the impact of COVID and the innovation we've seen in the skills sector. The UK is very lucky and privileged to have been partners with ASEAN for a long number of years, with a big number of skills organisations already working in the region. COVID brings about a new era in digital support for education, and we've all got to get on board with that. There are many industry sectors that have been impacted by COVID in different ways, some negatively, some positively. Our job is to ensure that we have the skilled workforce to cope with whatever changes have been happening. In particular, young people have been hit hardest in terms of job losses and job changes. Although we've seen that impact spread across all of the age ranges, it is in the young people's category that we see most negative impact. COVID-19 has also had an impact on wages. 75% of workers are impacted negatively in some way and have lost some wages as a result of this pandemic. The skills that people need are changing, and the way in which those skills will be gained is changing as well. Whether you're in Vietnam or in the UK, it doesn't matter. Everyone is having to make that change. So the question on everybody's lips is, why does this matter? Well, quite simply, it matters because the way in which we have to use technology in an innovative way to deliver skills to the front line has changed rapidly, and we're all involved in that process. And in doing so, we still must make sure that we enable people to reach those inclusive and equitable high quality training programs that give them the skills to get on in life. And the UN Sustainable Development Goals, of course, are an ambition for everybody at the moment. So we must make sure that education still achieves those. It is a well-known fact that 75 to 80% of young people in primary education today will be employed in jobs that have yet to be created. And the responsibility is yours and mine to make sure that those young people have the real skills that they need to be able to have a long-term career. Policy development must keep up with the way that the world is changing, and businesses have to be able to keep up with the way that the policy is being implemented and the way that they trade, and individuals have to keep up with the technology that is being developed on a daily basis around them. So that means the type of skills, specialist technical skills that they need, are ever more important. But so are the foundational skills, and the core skills, and the transferable skills, and of course entrepreneurial skills, and the digital skills, which is what we're going to come back to during this presentation. There are many benefits to be had from skills. I'm not going to read out the list that's in front of you, but whether it's from economic resilience to adaptability of individuals in the labour market, the way that we develop those skills in an interconnected planet, in an interconnected way, over a long period of time, lifelong learning is the key essence of what we're really driving. that leads to a diverse skills landscape. And that diverse skills landscape includes MOOC and virtual reality and artificial intelligence. It includes assessment and curriculum development and language and so much more. The COVID pandemic has, in essence, pushed education establishments and teachers into a whole new world. They've had to adopt new digital practices. They are teaching people that are, you know, remote students, and they don't meet with them very often. So it's got to be a lot more interactive. And all of these elements make it much more difficult for teachers to be able to impart that knowledge. But it's happening, and it's happening in a really exciting way. We're seeing lots of innovation in the classroom, and that is portraying itself in a remote way. We're seeing teachers become much more effective in the way that they deliver that curriculum. There is much more agility because, of course, we're all living in a changed world and a changing world a daily basis sometimes. So we have to have that agility. And in the process, they still have to manage the risks that come with that. As an enabler, what we are seeing are lots of innovations, as we've already mentioned. We are seeing efforts now in looking at teacher workload on redressing some of those issues where teachers need to look at that workload and how they manage assessments. We're seeing a huge push on coding and robotics and science, technology, engineering and mathematics. We're seeing lots of artificial intelligence being used in a really dynamic way. And of course, a big drive from ministries to make sure that policy supports this new way of building and delivering education. The UK is at the forefront of innovation and has a large number of education and training organisations which are working with technology providers to produce world-class, high-quality curriculum that really makes a difference to students in the workplace, whether they're new entrants or whether we're talking about mature workers that need to transfer from one sector to another. So if it's talent management or whether it's product development or whether it's actually for trade and distribution, you know, the UK has that kind of expertise. And what we're seeing is this EdTech use is across the range of infrastructures that are required, whether it's content, whether it's software and platforms, whether it's hardware, or whether it's the connectivity. And in that process, you know, we need to be thinking about the low-tech solutions as well as the high-tech solutions, because, of course, not everybody has high-speed broadband, and so we have to look at those innovative ways. In the UK, we've been changing lots of policy around our apprenticeship and technical and vocational programmes. So now we have two individual pathways that are very much aligned. So a TVET pathway as well as an academic pathway. And once you've achieved your T-level qualification, you can use the credits from that to enter into academic education if that's what you want, or to continue in the vocational stream of activity. And either is just as credible as each other. Our learning system has become much more flexible and diverse, whether you're in a further education college or whether you're actually in a workplace completing an apprenticeship with an employer. The technology and the innovation doesn't stop, and it really, the kind of destination is about making sure that those students use that technology to get the skills they want and the skills they need, of course. And that's why this flexible range of learning, whether in a college environment or whether in an employer environment, is so important. Our technologies for education have to meet that diverse range of circumstances for a diverse range of students. To support students across ASEAN in achieving digital skills, the BrightThink Digital Academy from the UK is offering a free foundation digital skills online bootcamp to any student in ASEAN until the 31st of December 2021. As part of this free program, students will cover a number of topics, including first steps in using digital skills, communication applications within digital skills, demonstrating online safety, developing your knowledge of skills and capabilities in a world of digital, how to process and deal with transactions online, and problem solving using digital technologies and digital skills. accompanying this world-class program is a range of learner support. So your learners will be able to log into live lessons or watch replays. They will also have access to a live skills coach every day. There's also an opportunity for learners to progress to undertake higher level accredited qualifications in digital skills and digital technologies. So here is the link for you to register. All you need to be able to do is to take that link and go to your browser, register free of charge, and you will start your journey to developing your digital skills for the future. And we hope that you'll enjoy that program. As we all know, from the delivery of decent skills and high quality skills, there is an instant benefit and real-time impact to be had by employers, by students, and by society in general, whether that is about reaching competency standards or whether it's about us identifying and optimizing that supply and demand, or whether it's about, you know, that targeted investment in skills. The UK can support you in all of these development areas, right from the initial labor market intelligence all the way through curriculum development, standards development, train the trainer, train the teacher, and building that capacity in the classroom, or of course for remote learning, whether that is into the realms of how that translates into competency. The great thing about the UK focus in technical and vocational education, whether it's remote or in the classroom, is it remains sector focused, it's demand driven, and contextualized to fit the local circumstances. Why not take a moment to watch this clip?
Okay, there you have it, our keynote presentation from United Kingdom.
And there are many questions.
Yeah.
How did they get the presentations live from Mr. Jonathan Ledger?
Actually, Mr. Ledger has shared in his presentation his email address. So our participants, particularly those who are asking, like Abdul Walid bin Haji Misli, and the others who are Ms. Ziana Haji Mahmood, they're asking about the link to the bootcamp. I think we have... This presentation has generated a lot of interest about the bootcamp and then particularly our TVET partners. So please, you can directly coordinate with him. But we can also share with you the presentation. This presentation, it will be uploaded on our website.
Our SEAMEO website.
Or you can just scroll back. If you look at the YouTube, you scroll back the YouTube to the time frame where he showed the link and his email address so that you can easily... go to the information that you need.
Yes, and I suggest you to contact Mr. Jonathan Legend directly, and his email address already shown on the last slide. You know, you just scroll back to a little bit, and then you can capture his email address and send his email address after this session.
Okay, so after the keynote presentation, but before I give you the floor for the digital transformation, I would like to acknowledge the more than 1,100 participants viewing us on YouTube. So thank you very much for learning with us in this Learning Thursday. And now, Piapa, what is next after the keynote?
Well, for the next session is about the digital transformation. And for this chapter, we have two speakers from China and Hong Kong. UNESCO Ishii from the higher education will present about the smart classroom project and online training for teacher development. And however, we would like to emphasize that this presentation is not just only higher education mm-hmm. teachers, but the secondary school teachers and the TVET teachers can join them as well. And for the second presentation from Ednuma, United States, and the presentation highlights the digital solution for young children. And the mm-hmm. presentation is very interesting because it's so very colorful that mm-hmm. the Southeast Asian children and teachers can make use of the solution that will be offered by Ednuma.
Yeah, because in the previous lecture series, we always get this recurring question about how we can facilitate learning, particularly for the young kids, those yes. between 5 and 8. So I think they will learn so much in this presentation.
Yes, please join the presentation from China and Hong Kong.
Okay.
Education is the most effective means of reducing poverty and inequality and encouraging social inclusion. UNESCO Aiche, the 10th education sector UNESCO Category 2 center in the world, is located in the Southern University of Science and Technology, Shenzhen, China. Aiche cooperates with Chinese high-tech enterprises and fosters partnerships with top-notch universities in Asia, Africa, along the Maritime Silk Road to build the digital education link.
尊敬的埃塞尔·艾克尼斯主任，各位教育部部长、女士们、先生们、朋友们，作为联合国教科文组织下属的二类中心。 创新中心紧密围绕联合国可持续发展目标4、2030全球教育议程，通过与各国旗舰大学的国际合作，充分发挥知识生产、能力建设、技术支持、信息共享的职能，促进亚非高等院校的数字化转型，扩大终身学习和优质平等教育的机会。
Funded by the Shenzhen Municipal Government, Aiche carried out the UNESCO Shenzhen Funds in Trust project in Asia Pacific and Africa. It not only supports Cambodia and Sri Lanka to launch capacity building and teaching practices, but also assists 10 African countries in strengthening their local systems of higher education quality assurance.
东南亚地区的高等教育一直是我们关注的重点。今年7月，中心与东南亚教育部长组织秘书处签署了合作谅解备忘录，并在此框架下正式开启了就如何运用信息通讯技术手段提升东南亚国家高等教育公平和质量的交流和对话。
On December 8, 2019, UNESCO Aiche, together with 11 global HEIs, 4 Chinese HEIs and 8 Chinese enterprises, signed the letter of intent to join the IIoE network, which marks the co-initiation of International Institute of Online Education.
2020, IIoE gradually developed into a multilingual and multifunctional online education platform, which provides teachers in developing countries with free and open online ICT learning resources. IIoE has also formulated an ICT competency framework for educators in higher education to build their capacities related to online and blended teaching and learning, education management, and ICT-enabled frontier research.
Aiche has cooperated with Widong and CreateView to launch the Smart Classroom project in selected partner HEIs.
Smart Classroom aims to empower leading partner HEIs in order to improve education quality and promote education equity by taking full advantage of the great potential offered by ICT in order to achieve SDG 4, combining various elements of hardware devices and software applications. Smart Classroom addresses the challenges of resource scarcity in higher education, promote the transformation of traditional teaching learning modes, and improve the learning management system.
Fully functioning in Pakistan, Egypt, Djibouti, and Cambodia, smart classrooms have been put into use to mitigate the educational fallout and supplemented IIoE during the COVID-19 pandemic. Organized a series of online trainings and shared its rich experience in combating against COVID-19 by actively participating in various webinars. In the past few years, major international conferences and ICT-related seminars have been organized. An all-round platform for information sharing is established. As one of many shining examples of China's contribution in the international arena, iChe will keep rendering the benefits of ICT to more developing countries. This will provide equal opportunities for all to access equitable, quality higher education and expedite the collective efforts of all countries to achieve SDGs for a shared, innovative future of the world.
从可选项变为必选项，其优先级已从倡导和研究转变为实施和主流化的解决方案。而亚非发展中国家也面临着巨大的困境，能力建设是当务之急。创新中心致力于帮助大学培养具备SAT素养和能力的师资，并指导他们在教学实践中应用最前沿的技术，助力解决当前教育中断的困境。 帮助他们在机构和国家层面建立促进高等教育数字化转型的生态系统。作为SEAMEO网络的合作伙伴，创新中心将一如既往地大力支持秘书处在东南亚倡导的优质、全纳和公平的教育领域合作。中国有句古话：一花独放不是春，百花齐放春满园。创新中心期待着与东南亚教育部长组织 及各东盟国家在教育领域的合作迈上新的台阶。谢谢。
Good morning and welcome to today's presentation. We are very excited to introduce an innovative teaching solution for young children using EdTech. You are going to love it. But first, let me thank SEAMEO for inviting Enuma to join this lecture series. My name is Ming Wong and I'm the Vice President at Enuma, in charge of government relations and strategic partnerships. I would have loved to be doing this presentation live and be able to see all of you. But at least now you know what I look like. I welcome you to email me later with any questions or comments, as well as connect on LinkedIn. As you can see from the slide, my role at Enuma is to develop partnerships so that we can grow our company's impact and enable as many children as possible to learn how to read, write, and count. I first met Suin, Inuma's founder and CEO, in 2016, when she presented at an impact investing conference in Hong Kong. Inuma was still a young startup then, and she was not yet an Ashoka Fellow. The Schwab Foundation would not recognize her talents for another 4 years. But I already saw the passion in her eyes, even in those early days. Something Suin said at her talk really impressed me. People quit playing online or mobile games either because they are too easy or too difficult to advance to the next stage. The challenge is finding the right balance to keep gamers engaged. The best design games should be enjoyable by millions of people, regardless of their level and ability. In the gaming industry, there is no such thing as a bad gamer, only a poor game designer. And this is exactly the gamification philosophy that she brings to early learning. Imagine for a moment if all teachers were to adopt this same philosophy. There is no such thing as a bad student, only a poor teacher, or an under-resourced education system. If we dare to make this mindset change, every child will be able to learn and no one will be left behind. Unfortunately, the reality is very different. This is a photo of an all too familiar scene, in this case of a school in Tanzania, where over 100 students crowd into a small classroom with not enough desks or chairs. Although the situation in Southeast Asia may not be as dire as in Africa, our schools face many of the same problems. Classes are too large because there aren't enough teachers. Teachers are under pressure to complete a set of lessons in a fixed period of time. And too often, the focus is on exam preparation. So the end result, according to new data from UNESCO, is that 387 million children of primary school age, or 56% of the total, will not achieve minimum levels of proficiency in reading and arithmetic. And the saddest part of it is that two-thirds of them are actually attending school. UNESCO suggests there are three common problems. First, lack of access, with children who are out of school having little or no chance to reach a minimum level of proficiency. Second, a failure to retain every child in school and keep them on track. And third, the issue of the quality of education being delivered in the classroom. So far, educators have focused only on training more teachers and increasing the supply of qualified teachers, particularly in developing countries. To achieve universal primary and secondary education by 2030, as part of UN SDG 4, countries must recruit 68.8 million teachers. In Southeast Asia, the problem is less severe compared to, say, Sub-Saharan Africa or South Asia. But still, over 6 million teachers are needed to be recruited by 2030. So the question is whether EdTech can finally solve our education crisis. In 2014, the XPRIZE Foundation decided to find out by launching a competition to challenge teams from around the world to see if anyone can design a tablet-based app to enable children to teach themselves basic reading, writing, and arithmetic within 15 months. To encourage the best teams to apply, Elon Musk donated $15 million as prize money. Over 400 teams from 40 countries answered this call, and five finalists were chosen for the 15-month field test in Tanzania, where 3,000 children between the age of 7 and 11 took part, including 300 children who form a control group. It was a tough competition, but finally, in May 2019, 5 years after the competition was first announced, Inuma's entry, Kikit School, was named a co-winner of the competition. In winning the XPRIZE competition, Inuma proved two things. One, it is indeed possible for children to learn basic numeracy and literacy on their own. And two, the quality of software is really key. As the results of the competition showed, the learning outcomes of Kiki School far exceeds those of our competitors as well as the control group. You can find a copy of our field test report on our kikitschool.com website under the impact section. Since winning the X Prize, we have seen Kiki School used in many rural communities in Tanzania and other parts of East Africa. School can also be found in refugee camps in Bangladesh, where out-of-school children are learning on their own at home-based schools. Meanwhile, in Korea, Enuma is working with the Korean government to provide in-home programs for children of immigrant families to improve their Korean. These are typically families with a Korean father and a mother from China or Southeast Asia. Next, our latest initiative and highlight for today, Enuma School, which we have just launched in Indonesia in January. It has three components: local language literacy in Bahasa Indonesia, mathematics also in Bahasa, and English as a second language. Over 600 games in all for children to learn on their own and with minimum adult supervision from as young as 5 years old. The app can be downloaded onto a smartphone or a tablet, and once downloaded, no internet access or data is required. We are very excited about this new product, which is made possible by the generous financial support of our sponsors, the Head Foundation of Singapore and GMP and PSMI, two sugar plantations that are based in Lampung, Sumatra. Since the beginning of last month, we have been testing a beta version of Sekolah Enuma with the help of 600 children in Lampung and Medan to make sure that the games we designed are fun to play for them, not too easy and yet challenging enough for them to remain engaged and learn. From Q3 of this year, we hope to launch more pilots in other cities and provinces in Indonesia, and we are looking for schools, NGO partners, corporates and foundations who are interested in working with us. And sometime in the beginning of 2022, we plan to launch a free version of Sekolah Enuma so that every family or school can download it for the children to play with. This free version will be for learning Indonesian only, and we plan to also launch a national literacy campaign with the help of all our partners. I'm delighted to now give you a sneak preview of Sekolah Enuma. Each device can support up to 10 logins, and students have their own profile account and can log in using a child-friendly icon password. In the main screen, the user will see three subject cards: Bahasa Indonesia, Math, and English. For each day, the user will play different games assigned to each daily lesson. In English, for example, the user will start learning simple letters of the alphabet, and later on, they will learn additional vocabulary and sentences by playing fun games like this labeling game, for example.
Hospital. School. Enam. Tujuh.
When users play math games, they will start with counting and writing numbers. And at higher levels, they will solve word problems and learn equations.
Hewan. Ayam betina. Kucing.
Daily lessons also include Bebek. Games, books, and videos. For example, for Indonesian
Saya
literacy games, you will start with letters and phonics, and then
Saya
leading up to reading and vocabulary. There will be spelling games
Dia
for phonics and vocabulary as well.
Yang pandai.
Like this fun
Dia
word kicker game.
Yang pandai.
When the users complete a daily lesson, they will receive a reward. Then they will be able to use the rewards to access a digital library. The The digital library contains games that kids have played before, as well as videos and books that they can read at their leisure. The videos have been contextualized and aligned with the curriculum in Indonesia. For example, we have videos on natural disasters, in this case, floods.
Festival Budaya di Sekolah.
All our books reflect Indonesian culture and they have been developed with the help of Indonesian illustrators and book writers.
Akan ada atraksi tarian, pentas musik, juga pembacaan puisi.
Well, that was a quick demo of Inuma School. While Inuma School is not yet available to everyone, you can request free download of Kikit School to see how we use gamification for education. Just go to the kikitschool.com website and you can try a free version until the end of this year. Thank you very much for joining us today. Goodbye.
Okay, so there you have it. Our more than 1,200 viewers on YouTube are very excited. They're asking about the freebies that our lecturers have shared.
Yes, that's right. And then many participants asking about how they could contact for the UK Bootcamp again. So our team will put the email address of Mr. Jonathan Legend, the TVET specialist from the UK International Trade, at the pin.
Yeah, it's already pinned. I checked.
Yeah, it's already pinned.
Already
so you just scroll to the pin, open the chat box of the YouTube, and then you will see the top message of the CMEO right at the pin, and then you just email to him directly if you're interested to join the bootcamp.
Okay, and meanwhile, if they're interested to know more about the Kikit School, I think our presenter from Enuma has already shared the site where you can have access to these materials as well.
Yes.
So now let's go to the third part on innovative teaching solutions. So we have two presenters, this time from Akadesia. I think Akadesia is joining us as well in the YouTube chat. Mr. Nilish Bhatia, co-founder and CEO, will be presenting professional development platforms for educators. While we'll also have a presentation from EEF Thailand, Dr. Udom Wong Singh, Director of Teachers and School Development Office, and he will be featuring the case study from Thailand. So friends, let us learn from these video lectures.
Hello, my name is Nilesh Bhatia, and I am the CEO and the co-founder of Acad Asia. Before I begin today's session on professional development platforms for educators, I would like to take this opportunity to thank the entire team from SEAMEO for organizing this event and for inviting us to be a part of this. Thank you, SEAMEO, and also thank you to all the attendees today who have taken time out from their busy schedules to be here with us. At Acad Asia, we are a Singapore-based mission-driven edtech business that aims to empower educators everywhere. COVID-19 has changed the education industry completely. Classes are being conducted online, and the expressions, "Can you hear me? Can you see my screen? Are you there?" have all become way too common. Some perhaps will say that the education industry was long overdue for change anyway, and that the pandemic has only just accelerated this change. This change, for better or worse, has forever changed the role of a teacher as well. Many of us have been accustomed to teaching the class from the front, the sage on the stage. But the new norm has redefined the role of the teacher. Now, teachers are instead required to be the guide by the side. Moreover, they are also expected to have fundamental know-how of instructional design and are the first responders when it comes to providing technical support to their learners during their online classes. In addition to this, teachers are required to have a growth mindset and are expected to be lifelong learners. They need to learn new pedagogical skill sets and have a mastery over several digital tools all at once in order to be able to do their jobs well. Unfortunately, all of these new expectations asked of teachers puts them under unfair stress. As a result, most teachers are trying to replicate the classroom experience on video conferencing systems, and for the learners, this is not a joke. Imagine you sitting for 4 to 5 back-to-back Zoom meetings in a day, with each meeting lasting for at least 40 minutes or more. It is no wonder then that teachers and learners alike are exhausted, and the engagement rates are very low when it comes to teaching online. Moreover, the pandemic has proven that not all students can access online education in the same way, as internet connectivity is still a challenge in some places. While we cannot solve all the inherent issues when it comes to online education, there are 3 specific things that we can do to improve. 1, teachers can learn new pedagogical and technical skills to help improve their understanding of instructional design. 2, if they do this, we will see that engagement rates among learners will also improve, because effective instruction design will create many opportunities for student engagement. 3, this will also result in teachers and learners not having to spend so much time on back-to-back synchronous sessions. All these things can improve if teachers are given the opportunity to join continuous professional development programs on a regular basis. Continuous professional development, or CPD, is the ongoing process of developing, maintaining, and documenting one's professional skills. And more so now than ever, CPD programs will allow teachers to constantly find new ways to improve the quality of teaching. This is very important, especially since it is a given that nowadays teachers must be lifelong learners themselves first if they are to set an example for their students to follow. This is important not just because we are in the midst of a pandemic, but even thereafter. The future of work requires all of us to be lifelong learners, else we risk being left behind when it comes to finding employment opportunities in the future. Up until now, CPD programs are being offered to teachers as webinars, just like this one. Though webinars are good for general basic information, they are unidirectional and do not really provide too many hands-on interaction opportunities with the material for the participants. Also, the participants may not have too many opportunities for a good discussion between themselves and the speaker. The other option available to teachers has always been workshops. Traditionally, these have been organized by the school, and the teachers don't really have too much of a say in which programs they would like to attend and which they would prefer to skip. Though workshops tend to be more interactive than webinars and allow for quality interactions between the attendees and the facilitator, they tend to be expensive and run on a fixed schedule. Meaning, if you're not available on that day or time, you can't attend the workshop. Finally, once the workshop ends, there is no real cost-effective way to seek the advice of the facilitator again. But now, teachers have another option to access professional development courses. Freeju. It is the largest online community of teachers in Asia, with over 50,000 teachers already on the platform. Here, teachers can access a variety of CPD programs and learn at their own time and own pace. Moreover, they learn by doing on the platform, because it has all the tools needed to design engaging lessons. The teachers can learn on their own or as part of a larger group, and the courses are currently available in English, Bahasa Indonesia, Hindi, and Mongolian, with more languages being added soon. If you are keen to learn more, I invite you to sign up for the Introduction to Online Teaching course on Freeju. It's free. And at the end of this 2-day course, which you can complete at your own time and own pace, you can even receive a certificate of completion from ACAD Asia Singapore. You can sign up quite easily by visiting www.bit.ly/SEAMEO-learn-more. I'll repeat the link again. It is www.bit.ly/SEAMEO-learn-more. Also, if you need more information about Freeju, or if you are an education institute interested in professional development courses for your staff, then please do contact us here. Thank you once again for your time and have a great day ahead.
สวัสดีครับขอต้อนรับทุกท่านเข้าสู่ช่วงของนวัตกรรมการสอนที่เป็นทางออกให้กับคุณครูทุกท่านครับผมนายอุดมวงศ์สิงห์ผู้อำนวยการสำนักพัฒนาคุณภาพครูนักศึกษาครูและสถานศึกษากองทุนเพื่อความเสมอภาคทางการศึกษาครับเพราะครูเป็นหัวใจสำคัญของระบบการศึกษาหากคุณครูมองเห็นและรู้จักเด็กๆทุกคนแล้วเชื่อว่าคุณครูก็จะสามารถจัดการเรียนรู้ให้กับเด็กๆทุกคนได้ไม่ว่าจะเก่งหรือไม่เก่งก็ตามดังนั้นพรบ.กองทุนเพื่อความเสมอภาคทางการศึกษาเนี่ยในมาตรา5วงเล็บ3และมาตรา5วงเล็บ6เนี่ยจึงกำหนดไว้ชัดเจนครับว่าจะต้องมีการส่งเสริมพัฒนาคุณภาพและประสิทธิภาพครูให้สามารถจัดการเรียนรู้ให้กับเด็กได้ทุกกลุ่มเพื่อลดความเหลื่อมล้ำทางการศึกษานะครับแล้วก็จัดให้มีการศึกษาวิจัยพัฒนานวัตกรรมและส่งเสริมให้มีสถาบันต้นแบบในการผลิตและก็พัฒนาครูด้วยสำหรับกสศและเครือข่ายภาคีร่วมพัฒนาโรงเรียนและนวัตกรรมทางการศึกษาก็ยังมีนวัตกรรมที่ส่งผลต่อการเรียนรู้ของเด็กให้มีโอกาสที่ดีขึ้นนะครับเพื่อสร้างความสมบูรณ์ภาพทางการศึกษาให้กับนักเรียนและเยาวชนทุกคนนะครับภายใต้แนวคิดที่สำคัญคือ All for Education นะครับซึ่งกสศจะมีกิจกรรมประชุมวิชาการนะครับให้กับคุณครูแล้วก็นักการศึกษานะครับทั้งในประเทศแล้วก็ต่างประเทศนะครับโดยทุกท่านสามารถติดตามข่าวสารได้ที่ www.afe.eef.or.th หรือ www.eef.or.th ดังนั้นกสศและเครือข่ายโรงเรียนพัฒนาตนเองจึงคิดค้นนวัตกรรมที่จะช่วยให้กับคุณครูเนี่ยสามารถจัดการเรียนรู้ให้กับเด็กนักเรียนได้อย่างมีคุณภาพเท่าเทียมกันแม้แต่ในช่วงระบาดของโควิด-19 นี้นะครับเพราะว่าการเรียนรู้ของเด็กนั้นหยุดไม่ได้นะครับโอกาสต่างๆของเด็กก็จะหยุดลงไปหากเด็กไม่ได้รับการเรียนรู้อย่างต่อเนื่องโดยเฉพาะในพื้นที่ที่ต้องเผชิญกับความยากลำบากชุดการเรียนรู้แบ็คบล็อกหรือกล่องดำเพื่อการเรียนรู้จึงเกิดขึ้นและกำลังจะนำไปช่วยนักเรียนในพื้นที่ยากลำบากในเร็วนี้นะครับโดยคุณครูจะทำหน้าที่เป็นโค้ชและผู้ปกครองจะทำหน้าที่เป็นเพื่อนเรียนรู้ไปพร้อมๆกับบุตรหลานของตนเองนวัตกรรมชิ้นนี้จะเป็นอย่างไรผมขอเรียนเชิญรองศาสตราจารย์ดร.ธัญวิทย์วิเชียรพันธ์ผู้อำนวยการสถาบันวิจัยและพัฒนานวัตกรรมมหาวิทยาลัยศรีปทุมวิทยาเขตชลบุรีขอเรียนเชิญครับ
ช่วงที่มีวิกฤตการณ์ที่เราก็เจอกันทั่วโลกโควิด-19 เนี่ยนะครับนักการศึกษาแล้วก็หลายๆภาคส่วนก็พยายามที่จะแก้ไขปัญหาเกี่ยวกับการจัดการเรียนรู้ในโรงเรียนแต่ส่วนใหญ่แล้วเนี่ยก็จะเป็นการจัดการเรียนรู้ที่เน้นไปทางการใช้เทคโนโลยีมาช่วยคำถามคือแล้วเด็กที่บ้านเขาไม่ได้มีเทคโนโลยีแบบนี้หรือว่าพื้นที่ที่มันมีความทุรกันดารในการเรียนรู้เนี่ยจะเรียนยังไงเราก็เลยคิดว่าน่าจะมีอะไรทุกอย่างนึงที่จะช่วยเด็กกลุ่มนี้ก็เลยมีโอกาสได้มาคุยกับทีมโค้ชของโครงการที่SQP ที่ทางกองทุนเพื่อความเสมอภาคทางการศึกษาเนี่ยสนับสนุนอยู่สิ่งที่เราเน้น self-directed learning เนี่ยไม่ต้องเป็นอะไรที่มันหวือหวามากแต่ว่าขอให้เป็นเรื่องใกล้ตัวในความใกล้เคียงกับความเป็นอยู่และปากท้อง
พอเราได้ธีมมาแล้วเนี่ยว่าชุดการเรียนรู้เนี่ยจะครอบคลุมในกลุ่มสาระอะไรบ้างกิจกรรมการเรียนรู้ก็จะถูกดีไซน์ออกมาว่าเด็กๆจะต้องมีชิ้นงานอะไรบ้างเด็กๆจะได้เรียนรู้เกี่ยวกับเรื่องอะไรบ้างยกตัวอย่างเช่นกิจกรรมของนวัตกรรมและเทคโนโลยีคุณครูวิทยาศาสตร์ก็จะเป็นแกนหลักในการออกแบบกิจกรรมเช่นกิจกรรมนักนวัตกรรมน้อยกับวิถีเกษตรยุคใหม่คุณครูวิทยาศาสตร์ก็จะตั้งธีมออกมาค่ะว่ากิจกรรมอะไรบ้างที่เด็กๆจะได้ทำในส่วนของวิชาวิทยาศาสตร์ส่วนคุณครูคณิตศาสตร์ก็จะเข้ามาเสริมหนุนว่าจะต้องใช้ความรู้เรื่องอะไรคุณครูก็จะร่วมกันดีไซน์ออกมาเป็นใบงานค่ะให้เด็กๆเนี่ยไปร่วมมือทำกันสุดท้ายแล้วเนี่ยเราก็ได้ชุดตัวชุดการเรียนรู้แบ่งออกมาเป็น4กลุ่มวิชาค่ะก็จะมีชุดการเรียนรู้ที่เป็นวิชานวัตกรรมและเทคโนโลยีสังคมและมนุษยชนวิทยาการการวิจัยแล้วก็สัมมาชีพศึกษาเรื่องของอุปกรณ์ที่จะต้องใช้ในแต่ละกิจกรรมทุกสถานที่หรือทุกพื้นที่ของประเทศไทยเนี่ยจะต้องใช้งานได้เป็นส่วนใหญ่จะประกอบไปด้วยชุดที่เป็นคู่มือค่ะในชุดวิชากระถางอัจฉริยะก็จะประกอบไปด้วยกระถางแล้วก็พืชที่เราให้ไปในวิชาสุนทรแสนสนุกจะต้องมีการติดอุปกรณ์ต่างๆลงไปเราจึงมีกาวร้อนให้เด็กๆหรือว่าบางอุปกรณ์นั้นจะต้องใช้กาวน้ำเราก็เตรียมความหลากหลายของอุปกรณ์ไว้ให้เด็กๆใช้เราก็จะมีอุปกรณ์เล็กๆตัวนี้ค่ะทำให้ชิ้นงานมีขนาดเล็กลงในรายวิชานวัตกรรมและเทคโนโลยีนะคะเราก็จะเตรียมอุปกรณ์กล้องขยายกระดาษลิสมาสกล้องจุลทรรศน์ค่ะ
ซึ่งคอนเซ็ปต์ก็คือกล่องดำเพราะว่ามีความเป็นปริศนาหน้าค้นหาเพื่อให้เด็กเนี่ยเขารู้สึกตื่นเต้นและอยากจะใช้มัน
ชุดกิจกรรมการเรียนรู้ด้วยตัวเองหรือ self learning package จะถูกออกแบบมาโดยคอนเซ็ปต์ที่ว่า1เด็กๆสามารถเรียนรู้ด้วยตัวเองคนเดียวได้โดยที่ไม่ต้องให้ใครเข้ามาช่วย2เด็กๆจะต้องสามารถลงมือทำกับกิจกรรมนั้นได้ขั้นตอนที่3ก็คือเด็กๆจะต้องผ่านกระบวนการคิดอย่างสร้างสรรค์นอกจากนั้นแล้วนะคะหากเด็กๆเกิดปัญหาเกิดขึ้นค่ะเขาจะต้องแก้ปัญหาหรือไปหาใครเพื่อทำให้เขาเรียนรู้กระบวนการเหล่านี้ได้สิ่งเหล่านี้จะถูกสอดแทรกลงไปในชุดการเรียนรู้ชุดนี้ค่ะ
สวัสดีท่านผู้ปกครองที่น่ารักและก็ลูกศิษย์ที่น่ารักของคุณครูในช่วงสถานการณ์โควิดทางโรงเรียนได้เตรียมสื่อออฟไลน์เพื่อที่จะให้นักเรียนได้เรียนรู
้มันก็ประกอบไปด้วยอุปกรณ์ในกล่องดำนี่เรียกว่าแบ็คบล็อกนะฮะส่วนนี้คือเป็นสื่อการสอนที่เป็นเอกสารประกอบสื่อชุดที่1เนี่ยมันเป็นเรื่องของสมุนไพรใกล้ตัวเรื่องที่2ก็คือเรื่องของฉันคือใครอันที่3เนี่ยสวนแสนสนุกมันเป็นการเรียนรู้สมัยใหม่เปลี่ยนการศึกษาของประเทศไทยเราจากการเรียนเป็นเรื่องให้เป็นบูรณาการโยงเข้าสู่ชีวิตจริง
เด็กที่เราทดลองใช้นี่ก็เชิญมารับทราบเรื่องนี้ด้วยนะครับโดยให้คุณครูเป็นคนอธิบายปรากฏว่าคุณครูก็ทำตารางโปรแกรมเลยว่าการใช้ช่วงนี้ควรจะทำอะไรก็จะมอบหมายคุณครูที่เรียนเขาจะไปตรวจเยี่ยมบ้านเสมอ
ลองดูซิว่าในกล่องนี้มันมีตั้งหลากหลายเนาะถ้าเราจะปลูกพริกเนี่ยเราควรจะเลือกอุปกรณ์อันไหน
น
ี่
ค่ะ
นี่นะมันคือกระถางเนา
ะ
ใช่ไหมฮะอันนี้ลูกทำอะไรนะ
แผ่นผังบ้าน
แผ่นผังบ้านนะแม่ลูกเนี่ยเขาก็มาจากบทเรียนนี่แหละครับUMI เนาะฉันคือใครเนี่ยเห็นไหมเขาก็จะออกแบบห้องนอนก็ดีตรงนี้นะห้องครัวห้องอาหารนะครับ
วันนี้เดี๋ยวคุณครูจะมาพานักเรียนทดสอบความเป็นกรดเป็นเบสของดินนะคะโดยอุปกรณ์ที่ใช้ก็คือกระดาษลิสมัสค่ะถ้าเปลี่ยนจากสีน้ำเงินเป็นสีแดงแปลว่าดินนั้นมีความเป็นกรดค่ะแต่ถ้าเปลี่ยนจากสีแดงเป็นสีน้ำเงินจะเป็นเบสค่ะ
ไอ้ฟิล์มเล็กๆมาติดตรงนี้ก่อนใช่ไหมลูกแล้วก็เอาเยื่อที่เราตัดมาบางๆใช่ไหมลูกแล้วมาติดตรงนี้ใช่ไหมลูกแล้วไอ้นี่มาใช้ทำอะไรเนี่ย
เอาไว้หยุดน้ำครับ
ไหนลองทำให้ดูสิแล้วต้องใช้แฟลตเนื้อเหรอ
ใช่ครับ
เห็นอะไรลูก
เป็นจุดครับ
เห็นจุด
ๆ
แล้วเคยสอนแม่ไหม
เคย
แล้วแม่ได้ดูยัง
ได้ดูแล้วค
่
ะ
เหรอแล้วสนุกดีไหม
สนุกค่ะ
พัฒ
ฒนาการได้ดีมากเพราะว่าผู้ปกครองเขาก็ยินดีที่จะเข้ามาเหมือนกับกลายเป็นครูอีกคนหนึ่งเลยเข้ามามีส่วนร่วมในการเรียนการสอนของเด็ก
ตัวนักเรียนนะคะเปลี่ยนแปลงไปเยอะทีเดียวเลยค่ะเขาจะมีความรับผิดชอบมีวินัยในตนเองมากยิ่งขึ้นนี่คือความเปลี่ยนไปที่คุณครูก็ภูมิใจนะคะ
ซึ่งทำให้เราค้นพบว่าจริงๆคุณท่าที่แท้จริงเนี่ยของกล่องใบนี้มันเป็นเรื่องของการสร้างนิสัยฝ่ายเรียนรู้ด้วยตัวเอง
ในอนาคตนักเรียนน่าจะพัฒนาในเรื่องของทักษะอาชีพทักษะชีวิตของเขาในการแก้ปัญหาที่จะอยู่ในสังคมข้างนอก
My name is สุภัสราลัยไทยสงฆ์ You can call me Pal Let's talk about my big family
เขาทำแล้วเขาก็นอนดึกทุกคืนเขาชอบแล้วเขาก็ไม่มีเวลาไปดูหนังการ์ตูนค่ะก็ถามว่าหนูอยากดูไหมเขาบอกว่าไม่อยากดูค่ะเขาชอบทำแบบนั้นก็สนุกดีค่ะ
ถ้าเป็นไปได้ก็อยากให้หลานคนนี้เขาพัฒนาตัวเองขึ้นโดยตัวเขาเองแต่ถ้ามีจุดนี้มามีส่วนช่วยได้มากเยอะมากเลยล่ะครับ
สมัยก่อนเรียนไม่มีแบบนี้นะครับก็รู้สึกดีใจแทนลูกครับผมมันจะได้มีโอกาสพัฒนาตัวเองไปเสริมทักษะของเราครับ
อันนี้เป็นความรู้ใหม่แล้วก็มันเป็นความรู้ที่บูรณาการหลายวิชารวมกันแล้วก็ได้พัฒนาตัวเองแล้วรวมควบคู่กันเขาจะได้สนิทกับครอบครัวมีเวลาว่างในครอบครัวมากขึ้นมีความอบอุ่นมากขึ้น
มันจะมีเด็กบางกลุ่มเช่นการช่วยพ่อแม่ทำงานเนี้ยเขาต้องขาดเรียนไปบ่อยๆแต่ถ้าเราใช้วิธีนี้ไปเป็นทางเลือกของเขาถ้าวันไหนเขาไม่มาโรงเรียนเขาเรียนหนังสือได้เขาสามารถที่จะเรียนรู้ได้ตลอดเวลา
That is very interesting, Black Box, right?
Yes, yes. I think we have generated so much interest in the presentations made by Acadesia, and we're glad that our peers, our colleagues from Acadesia are responding to the queries on YouTube.
That's right. And then, and we also would like to invite the participant to take your photo and post on the Facebook. And please do not forget to hashtag SEAMEO-Partners, one word together, SEAMEO-Partners.
Yes, so that we can see it on our Facebook page as well. And we can feature them in our next lecture on Feb 18.
Yes, that's right. And for the next chapter is about the innovation for TVET. This is the last chapter. And there are two presenters. The first presenter is from CEAIE, from China. And the organization would like to invite other countries, such as Indonesia, Malaysia, and Philippines, to co-develop the digital curriculum sharing platform. And for the presentation of CEIE today, they will showcase the successful digital platform between Thailand and China. And however, the organization would like to invite the students from other Southeast Asian countries to explore or experience the virtual training system from this platform. And it is free to join again. And for the last presentation is from the LabTech International Indonesia. The presentation highlights the virtual TVET and 21st century training for TVET educators and students. So there will be another last two interesting presentation.
Yes.
Please take the photo from your mobile phone when you see the very interesting slide, or even like the link or email address, so you can join.
Okay. So let's learn from this.
Thailand is an important partner for China to jointly build the Belt and Road. The reserve of vocational skilled talents will add new impetus to the economic development of China and Thailand. In order to further promote the development of vocational education in the two countries, with the support of the Vocational Education Commission of the Ministry of Education of Thailand and the Chongqing Municipal Education Commission, Chongqing Vocational Institute of Engineering, and the Confucius Institute on Kong Kang University in Thailand, jointly launched the China-Thailand Vocational Education Alliance. the establishment of the China-Thailand Vocational Education Alliance is a milestone in the development of vocational education in the two countries and will open a new chapter in the vocational education of China and Thailand. At present, the main cooperation projects of the alliance include the exchange of teachers and students, online course production, academic research, etc. It is a leading vocational education cooperation project between China and Thailand. In order to enrich the vocational education learning resources of the two countries, the Alliance has created an independent online course system. Currently, there are 22 Chinese, English, and Thai trilingual courses on the China-Thailand Vocational Education Alliance online course platform. The online course standards of the China-Thailand Vocational Education Alliance online course platform have been made after preliminary research and scientific planning. The standards are fully based on the professional teaching standards for higher vocational schools of the Ministry of Education of China and the Higher Vocational College curriculum standards issued by the Vocational Education Committee of the Ministry of Education of Thailand. The standards have been made after solicited opinions from experts, teachers, and students of the two countries. The courses on the China-Thailand Vocational Education Alliance online course platform are jointly constructed by member institutions such as Chongqing Vocational Institute of Engineering in accordance with course standards. The content includes road engineering, PLC control technology, and other fields. The courses are equipped with English or Thai subtitles and are equipped with the relevant course materials. The course production is divided into the title, course summary, knowledge points combining, practice and after class exercise, etc., has formed a complete course teaching system. In addition to the course videos, the platform also has an examination system and a virtual training system. In the examination system, the platform divides the course test papers, integrates by difficulty. Students can choose test papers for testing according to their learning situation. In addition, the platform is also equipped with an advanced virtual training system. In the virtual training system, students can choose to conduct virtual training according to the courses they have learned. It has solved the problem that students in the epidemic cannot go to school or go to enterprises to participate in training. The China-Thailand Vocational Education Alliance online course platform is an open platform. No matter where you are, you can directly enter the system. Enter your mobile phone number to register for free online courses and enter the exam system for testing. Enter the URL of our platform. Choose Chinese, Thai, or English. Here we choose English. Click here to enter your username and password or register new user information. Input your phone number and password. Choose institute and course. Such as a road engineering online course. You can choose the courses and learn. Thank you. This the examination system. Here we can see the virtual training system. This is the virtual training for auto parts. In Thailand, many schools use online courses videos on the platform as supplementary teaching videos. Due to the impact of the epidemic, students study online at home. Teachers play the platform's online course videos as teaching materials for students to watch. Teachers and students who use platform online courses have many praising words for courses on the platform.
ในช่วงการแพร่ระบาดโรคโควิด-19เป็นการปรับปรุงการเรียนรู้ของเรา
Currently, the China-Thailand Vocational Education Alliance is working hard to build various courses. It is planned that by the end of 2021, more than 100 courses will be launched on the China-Thailand Vocational Education Alliance online course platform. The content includes Chinese language skills, 5G technology, electronic engineering technology, and other hot and key fields, which will greatly help teachers and students in teaching and learning. The following is website and QR code of the China-Thailand Vocational Education Alliance online course platform. China-Thailand Vocational Education Alliance sincerely invites you to try out the China-Thailand Vocational Education Alliance online course platform and join our learning team.
Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. My name is Brad Kerr. I'm the Digital Programs Manager for LabTech International Limited. Firstly, a very big thank you to SEAMEO for arranging these webinar sessions. I hope you've been enjoying them as much as I have, and I look forward to presenting to you today. What we're going to be talking about is what is virtual TVET and how virtual TVET can have an impact on teachers and students. To do this, we need to look at 21st century training so we can prepare the teachers and the students to be Industry 4.0 ready. Four very important things here are innovation. Innovation makes it very engaging for the learner so they can learn much better. We look at the quality. The quality means it needs to look realistic. Relevance means it's relevant to industry, not 30 years ago, but now and the future. And it has to be an employable skill. So those four things are very important when you look at implementing virtual TVET. So what is virtual TVET? Virtual TVET is using realistic 3D gaming technology for teaching and learning. This makes it very easy for the learners when they go out and work on the real things that it looks realistic. Then it's got to be interactive. Interactive on the screen, it's like they're actually learning a technical process and a skill from simulations, from assembly, disassembly. Then how is it delivered, right? Is it delivered by, we've discussed, tablets, smartphones, augmented reality, virtual reality, mixed reality? And then is it in a hybrid approach? How much is done at home or away from the workshop, and how much is done in the workshop? And then it needs to be delivered through a TVET learning management system. Provide teacher and student performance data for managers and institutes. We need to be able to get that data, activities and assessments. Then we look at enabling on and off campus, anywhere, anytime learning. So the benefits of virtual TVET, are it will lower costs by 50 to 75%. And that is because we're redesigning the labs for digital learning. Less equipment, different equipment. Digital upgrade is equivalent to a physical lab upgrade. Quicker implementation time. Traditional methods take time and huge cost and have poor scalability. Digital deployment is much quicker. Teacher support. It reduces shop time for students. We've got organisations around the world already and teachers telling us it's reducing their time over 50%. They're now finding they only need to spend 30% of their time teaching the hands-on skills because they know so much more. So it frees up the teacher's time now to mentor the students. Enables teachers to train more students and has increased capacity of labs and schools. So curriculum upgrading provides a virtual upgrade to older labs so the instructional materials can improve the curriculum delivery. Up-to-date material. It's easier to keep the curriculum and content up to date. Keeping up with the latest technology and industry needs and upgrading and adapting new courseware and materials. And finally, performance monitoring. We can look at the performances of the student, the teacher, the school, the state, the country. So let's look at what type of TVET users. So this is based on LabTech Academy, over 26,000 users around the world. And these are the types of learners. So it's not just students. You know, yes, they're a large part of it, 74.3%. But then we've got the teachers, the instructors, the trainers, the professors, 11.6% of those users. And then we've got DIY, 9.2%, government, NGI, OGO, 3.6%, and other 1.4%. So this is telling us something, that it's great that the instructors also need the professional development, and we've got the people out there already that are wanting to learn and upgrade their skills to deliver this new technology using virtual TVET. LabTech Academy country, I'm very happy to say we're covering 156 countries now in 9 months. So it's had a big impact already. And of course, the largest usage is coming out of the Philippines and also in Pakistan, the US, and in parts of South America. But again, we have very good coverage around the world now. This is as of the 16th of January, looking at some of the grade averages, and this is the impact that it's having. So I've just taken out of the learning management system some topics, three topics in each subject area, being air conditioning at the top, the middle one electrical, the bottom one automotive. You can see the number of users that have done those three topics. So HVAC, over nearly 5,000, electrical nearly 7,000, automotive just over 6,000. So if you look at the grade averages, pre-test 50.2%, then after they've been through the study material, post-test average 93.5%. In this area here of vocational training, I remember back in the mid-2000s, you were looking at probably average post-test scores in the high 70s if we were lucky. So if we pick some of these out, if I look at HVAC, you know, I go to the far right in the orange, so that's just over here, I've got accumulator pretest 4.22, so 42.2%. Then after they've been through the study material, 93.8%, 9.38. So the average time that people are spending on each topic is around 3.5 hours. If I look at automotive and I do hybrid transaxle, 5.13 pretest, post-test 9.12. So that's just giving you an idea that the impact this is having out there with the teachers, the learners, the industry, and also government, DIY also. So let's look at some recent training that we've done. Here's a hybrid approach where it was done online and face-to-face with a group of teachers. So this was done with the Ministry of Labour in Indonesia. They profiled and selected 19 champion teachers, right? So that we actually pre-tested them 43%. After they went through and did the online and the hands-on, post-test score 94.5%. This was in Autotronics. Average increase of 51.5%. So let's look at another approach here, and that is what makes it most effective virtual TVET and what are the learning elements? You've got to have a methodology, and at LabTech we apply this methodology through everything that we do. That is, we have a glossary, we have a background theory. It's like having an up-to-date textbook online that we have subject matter experts around the world maintaining it all the time, and you can search and index that background theory at any time. We have videos, interactive learning. So this is the skill part of it. This is where you can interact on the screen, look at component descriptions, rotate them around, look at them in 3D. You have assembly and disassembly, how components assembled and disassembled, and then how they operate. Okay, and again, it's all interactive, and the same with our formative assessments. Formative assessments, they get to actually assemble, drag and drop. They can use their mouse, they can use the keyboard, they can use their finger on a touchscreen. They get to put together the components on the screen. And of course, our summative assessments are our pre and post tests. So effective 21st century training, I'm not to go into detail here, but when we deliver this training, we look at the four C's. We look at communication, collaboration, creativity, and critical thinking. Everything we do when we deliver our 21st century training using technology, we apply the four C's. So here's some recent 21st century training. This was a project that was done with the Asia Development Bank, ADB, and the ministry in Indonesia, Polytechnics. They profiled the teachers and we put them through the four C's of 21st century learning, both online and face-to-face. Pre-test score 65.3%, post-test score average 95.1%, increase 29.8%. Again, these figures tell us that the teachers out there are actually grasping this. They want to learn. They want to learn how to change and develop new lesson plans to apply this in the classroom. At LabTech, we are all about helping teachers and students develop life skills that are relevant to industry now and be Industry 4.0 ready. So let me actually show you now quickly. I'm going to go live online to our cloud so you can see it very quickly here. So again, I'm accessing the cloud and there's my courses there. I then get a selection of the courses that I'm enrolled in. I'm going to go into HVAC, air conditioning and refrigeration. Now I get a list of instructions here. I get a list of whether it's what the objectives are. I take a pre-test, one attempt. I go through my study material, step 3. Step 4, take the post-test. Step 5, download the certificate of completion if I've achieved 80% or higher in my post-test. These are all my topics here. Again, these can be rearranged with a custom TVET learning management system. Here I'm going to go into my reciprocating hermetic compressor. I'm going to go straight into the study materials because I just want to show you quickly a operational simulation. So when this comes up, again, this is live from the cloud. Okay, so I can speed my simulation up here. I can turn off the discharge gas. I can turn off the suction gas. I can rotate my 3D model here so I can look at it from a different angle. Turn back on the suction gas. Again, very interactive. Now what I'm going to do is that give everyone the opportunity, just go back to my presentation here. The first 10 institutes that contact LabTech Academy, and we'll be putting my email address in the chat when this goes and is presented, but just for those of you, it is brad@labtech.org. So that's brad@labtech.org is my email address. The first 10 institutes that contact us, right, we will give you 2 months free access for 2 teachers and 20 students. And so we can monitor those students within the class. The teachers will actually be put in a group for that institute. So again, please contact brad@labtech.org to get your free access to LabTech Academy. Thank you very much. Look forward to hearing from you all soon.
Okay, thank you very much. So we have completed with all the 4 chapters of this lecture series. At this point, we'd like to thank our partners, yes. Piapa.
Thank you very much for the partner who contribute and produce the video and join in this lecture series.
Yes, yes. And for this last set, we have heard from Indonesia and from China. So the last one from LabTech, the first 10.
Yes,
so I can imagine the number of interest being generated from more than 1,100 participants joining us live on YouTube.
And we have about 5,500 who, you know, watching the playback.
Oh, yeah, yeah. So all in all, there's about more than 6,000 of us learning together in this lecture series. So now let's, before we answer the most asked question, please stay with us until the end of this session as we will first give you some reminders. The first reminder is about the Tsukuba Symposium. So you can see on your screen the QR code where you can get the information about the SEAMEO University of Tsukuba Symposium. That will be next Thursday. So that means our next lecture series will be on the 18th, the week after next, because we will be seeing you online. Yes,
that's right. And this is for free, right?
Yes, this is for free. And you may also access, the registration link is there. So please put out your mobile phones and get that QR code and register and take note of the YouTube link. The link to the event website is also placed there. So if you want to know more information about this, please visit that particular site.
And Rafi, there are many participants asking about the certificate of this session.
Oh, the certificate, we will get to that at the end of this presentation. So please hang on for that information. Our next announcement is about the SEAMEO Australia Education Links Award 2021. Mm-hmm. So the application is still ongoing and we will close the Google form on April 16. So we have actually uploaded a Google form where they can respond to the questions and submit their application for this award. The QR code is in the lower right part of the screen and the deadline is on April 16. Mm. And our next reminder is about SEAMEO Congress 2021.
Yes, that's right, coming soon in April.
Yes, and we're inviting all who are interested to submit mm-hmm. and present their papers. We are still accepting papers. For more information, please scan the QR code or visit that link. And we have actually prepared a video for you. So let's all watch this SEAMEO Congress video. Okay, for the next reminder, Piapa, would you like to share with our audience?
And again, we would like to invite all the educational institutions to take part in our SEAMEO Schools Network. And if you are the primary school, secondary school, vocational school, university or colleges, and also kindergarten school, you are invited in this our network. And we are inviting from 11 Southeast Asian mm-hmm. countries to take part in this school program. And at the moment, we have 1,000 nine institutions mm-hmm. under our network already, and the most population from Philippines and Indonesia. And we would like to invite other countries to join us as well. And please scan the QR code, and then you know, and the application form very simple, like asking the information, basic information about your school and the name of the coordinator. And if mm-hmm. you join in this school network, you will gain the benefit from joining our SEAMEO program. You will receive the news and the free scholarships, and also the free training courses from the SEAMEO and SEAMEO centers, and participating in the all the SEAMEO mm-hmm. programs and awards.
Okay, for our next announcement for the next lecture series, Piapa.
Yes, we will meet you again on 18 February. With the theme Future Skill for Student and IR 4.0 Solutions. Mm-hmm. And for this lecture series, we have too many presenters, you know.
So maybe our viewers can prepare their lunch as well while learning.
That's right. We have about at the moment 10 videos mm-hmm. from our partners, and the topic you see on the left hand side, enhancing innovative through STEM education, future skill for students, skill for futures, key enabling technology for IR 4.0, city-based education and AI, and virtual work experience. So these are about the how to improve the student skills and IR 4.0 knowledge and skills. And the next slide.
For our next announcement, this is about the SEAMEO lecture polls. Earlier, we have posted on the screen the link on YouTube. So for the result of this, we have 806 participants who joined the poll, and in the next session we'll be sharing you the word cloud. But the most repeated word, the most cited word, would be very informative, very innovative, and innovative teaching. So there, you can see there the results of this, and we are thanking everyone who participated in this poll. Thank you very much, and we are still waiting for your submissions in the Facebook using the hashtag that we shared with you, SEAMEO Partners, and we'll be sharing the results as well in the next lecture series on Feb 18. Right now, we'd like to also invite you to share, to follow us on Twitter. We have our own Twitter account where we can post the most updated news about learning activities, learning events of SEAMEO. So if you have your official Twitter accounts or your personal Twitter accounts, please look for us, search for us. Our handle is @SEAMEO_S, or just look for SEAMEO Secretariat and you will be brought to this page. Please feel free to tweet and retweet all our posts. And you may also put your pictures here and then use the hashtag #SEAMEOPartners so we can see it as well. Now let's go to the most asked question. So Piapa, would you like to share?
I think that this is the most asked question from our participant right now in our YouTube live. Many ask me about how to get the e-certificate of participation from this session. So you will see the link here and the QR code. You can scan QR code by using your mobile phone and you can access the form that you need to fill up your simple data such as like your name and email. Please ensure that when you put the name and the email address, you spell it properly. And the certificate will be given to you by the system. So whatever data that you provide to us, we are not able to fix your certificate. Please ensure the spelling of your full name and email address before submitting to us. And you have about 12 hours to fill up this form. And our IT is now, you know, helping us to pin the link and also the information on the chat box of the YouTube live.
Already pinned. So if you are on YouTube, joining us on YouTube live, you can just simply click the link.
That's right. And there are many questions also, that, you know, many participants saying that they cannot find the link of the certificate validation form. So if you click on the chat box on the top, you will see the link. You just access the link directly, or you can go to the SEAMEO Secretariat Facebook. You just type, you know, search the account name SEAMEO Secretariat, or you put the hashtag #SEAMEOPartners in your search box, right?
Yes.
Of your Facebook, and then you will find the slide of the certificate link and also the QR code.
Okay.
So this is, I hope that everybody can access the link easily from this information today. And please remind you that you have only 12 hours to enter the link of today.
Okay. I guess that's all for today. We have completed all the lectures and we hope to see you next week for the Tsukuba Symposium. And then the week after next, we'll have the next lecture series.
Yes. And then see you again next session.
So from all of us here in the SEAMEO headquarters in Bangkok, Thailand, we wish everyone a pleasant afternoon.
And stay safe and healthy. Okay. Bye-bye, everyone. Bye-bye.
Achieve our goals through partnership, creating opportunities.